Good day, good people. My name is Kabo Sekoele, and I'm an online math tutor here to help young children turn their struggles into their successes. In today's video, we're going to be talking all about tutoring centers. Firstly, we're going to be talking about what they are, how do they work, and whether or not they are worth your money. Now, in this video, I'm going to be focused particularly on math tutoring centers. There are science tutoring centers and language tutoring centers. However, I want to focus more on math because that's the predominant tutoring center that exists in our world today. Plus, I'm a math tutor. I'm biased. Firstly, what are tutoring centers? A tutoring center is a place you take your child to if you think they need additional help with their schoolwork. In this case, we're talking about math tutoring centers, so it is a place you take your child to if your child is struggling in mathematics and needs additional help with math. How do tutoring centers work? Firstly, your child is going to be assessed. They're going to see what level in math your child is in, and then afterwards, once they know how far your child is in math, they will assign them resources, homework, assignments, anything that would be meant to help your child up their level in mathematics. Now we're going to discuss whether or not it is worth your money. It all depends on their tutoring model. There are a couple of factors that make tutoring a success, but in this video we're only going to discuss two: the level of attention your child is getting and also the quality of tutoring your child is going to be getting. If your child is struggling in math, they need a considerable amount of individual attention. And unfortunately, tutoring centers typically have a high student to teacher ratio, meaning they normally have a lot more students than they do tutors. And this kind of brings us back to the classroom setup, which is exactly where children struggle in the first place. If your child is struggling in math, in order for them to flourish, they need, firstly, someone to identify what their pain points are. What are the recurring issues? What are the problems that they're facing in math? Then they need someone to help them, to actively help them, guide them, and show them the way. They need someone to help them through those pain points. If there is a high student to tutor ratio in your local tutoring center, chances are your child will not be getting the attention that they need to flourish. So speak to your local tutoring center, because it is true that not all tutoring centers have a high student to tutor slash teacher ratio. So find out from your local tutoring center how many tutors there are and how many students there are. If they say that they assign more than 3 students per tutor, that, in my opinion, it's quite high. It's bordering on the high side. If your child is assigned in a group that has more than 3 students and there's only 1 tutor, your child may not be getting the attention that they need. So my suggestion, go to a center that has at least less than 3 students per group, or find yourself an independent tutor where there's one-on-one individual attention that will be given to your child. I say 3 in a group because it does help having another child who has similar struggles going through the process with your child. They bounce ideas off of one another, they hear the questions that the other one has, and they learn from that. However, it becomes a problem when it is more than 3, 4, 5, 10, 20. That's way too much. There's no way your child is getting individual attention. And if they're only going to the tutoring center for 1 hour every week or 2 hours every week, they still need more individual time alone or in a pairing with a tutor. That then gives your child the attention that they need. Now we're going to be going into the quality of tutoring. To illustrate this to you as a parent, let's say you have a newborn baby and you have no idea how to handle babies. You've never done this before. This is your first time. So you decide to go and get 2 parenting books. The one is a how-to manual on how to be a parent. The second is a book full of principles that teach you about children and that help you on how to be a good parent. One of the first instructions in the how-to manual is that you must hit your child whenever they do something wrong and disrespectful. On the other hand, one of the first principles in the parent principle book is that your child needs to be disciplined for them to grow up into efficient and healthy and productive adults. Which book helps you to understand exactly why your child needs to be disciplined? Which book helps you to make more of an informed decision and gives you the room to do what you want? I think it would be the principle book. Math is exactly the same for your children. In order for your child to flourish, they need to be taught math principles and concepts. They don't need to be taught math methods. They don't need to be taught math calculations. They don't need to be taught how to solve problems. They need to be given principles that will enable them to think for themselves. Now, I'm sure you know this. There are tons of math tutors all over the world. Some of them, most of them, very affordable. There are tons of free math resources that are all over the internet. And yet there are still so many children that are struggling in mathematics every single year. Why is that? It's not because the kids are dumb. They're all just being taught the wrong thing. They're being given what they do not need. The reason I bring this up is because many of the tutors at these tutoring centers rely on the worksheets and the materials that are given to them by these tutoring centers. They focus more on helping your child get good grades in these worksheets and in these assessments that are given to them by the tutoring centers. And those worksheets, 99.999% of the time, focus their energies on developing your child's math skills, because they know that those skills are necessary. But what is even more important is teaching your child math principles, which is not the focus of these materials and worksheets. Your child can come up with their own methods if they're taught the right principles. They just have to be taught the right principles. And this is why you would see your child doing so well in many of the assessments that are at these tutoring centers. But when it comes time for the test at school or the exam at school, the grades don't match up. It's because your child has been trained according to the skills that they've been taught at the tutoring center, but they have not been given the right principles that they could use to develop their own methods, their own ways of doing things, which is vital if you want to get good grades and is a sign of math mastery. You cannot develop math mastery if you have only been trained on how to calculate and solve problems. The only way you can develop in your math skills is if you've been taught the right things, principles and concepts. So to see if the tutoring center in your local area gives your child the kind of tutoring and the quality of tutoring that they need to grow and flourish, go on Google, type in there, for example, I'm going to use an example here, Kumon worksheets. And see what kind of worksheets are being offered. Does it focus a lot on methodology? Does it focus a lot on calculations? Or do they ask your child questions that help them to reason on the information that they've been given? Does it help your child to think on the concepts that they've been taught? Or is it all about developing their math skills and step-by-step instructions on how to calculate and solve problems? These worksheets can also be found at these local tutoring centers, so you can go in there and ask them if they have any samples that they're willing to give you, so you can look through them and see. It's all a matter of being proactive as a parent and looking for the best solution for your child, because there is a solution out there, but only you as a parent can get them to where they need to be in order to receive these resources and in order to receive this attention that they need. So be proactive in your efforts to help your child. In closure, parents, please do your research. Find out who you're going to be giving your money to. Get to know these institutions. Find out if they give your child the right level of education, the right level of attention, as well as the best quality tutoring. Thank you all so much for making it to the end of this video. I hope you found it helpful and insightful. If you are looking for an independent math tutor, like I said, my name is Kabo Sekoele and I am an online math tutor. So you can go ahead, go to my website and see when you can schedule a free consultation with me, and I cannot wait to meet you. If you're a parent who wants to identify the problem areas that your child may be facing and how you can help them practically, go down to the description. I put a link in there for you. I created a free guide that helps parents identify what the issues may be with their children and also helps them find out how they can help their children. So you can go ahead and download that. I'll leave the link down in the description. Once again, thank you so much for tuning in, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.